Hey friends, thanks for joining us for Redeemer Kids this evening. I'm just here playing with some Legos. Do any of you guys enjoy building with Legos? Well, today, Renee will be sharing Jesus' lesson about the wise and foolish builders. Please tune in.
Hi guys, welcome to Redeemer Kids. My name is Renee and I am a team member, a part of Redeemer Queens Park. We are so happy that you are able to join us today. And today we're gonna talk about a story that kind of gives us a choice, a decision that we have to make at the end of it. So, I don't know about you guys, but every summer I go on break and I go to the beach with my family. Now, I have a pretty big family. There's like 20 of us, right? So pretty big. Now, we always decide to make a really big sandcastle. My brothers, my dad, all my nieces and nephews, we got our shovels, we got our buckets, we make this really big sandcastle. We spend a lot of time on it and it's a lot of fun. But guess what? We go home, we have dinner, we go to bed, we come back the next day. Do you think it looks the same? No, of course it doesn't. It doesn't look the same. It's probably gotten water, the tides come in, maybe other people were playing with it. It's kind of fallen down and in a mess. Here's my other question. Have you ever been to the palace? Now, I've been a couple times. When I was a little girl, I actually saw the palace and it was really crazy how big and beautiful it is. Now, I just moved here, so I went and saw the castle or the palace a couple months ago, and guess what? It didn't change. It looked exactly the same. I remembered it from when I was 8 years old to now. It didn't change at all. Now, what is the difference between that sandcastle and the royal palace? Well, we've got one made out of sand, and we've got one that's built on rock with brick. One of these is more dependable than the other. That palace isn't ever going to change, but the sandcastle that I make doesn't even last maybe a few hours. Now, what we're going to talk about today is a story that we see in the book of Matthew, one of the books of the Bible. Now, Jesus is telling us this story about a man who built his house on sand, kind of like our sandcastle, and then we see the story about a man that built his house on the rock, like the palace. Now, a way to think about it, which one do you think lasts? Now, and I'm not just talking about nice weather like today. What is gonna happen to those houses when the rain starts pouring down and there's wind and all of these things start happening? Which house would you rather be in a storm? You're gonna be sitting through a storm in the house that's built on sand or the one that's built on a rock? Now, we have to think through which one makes sense, the sand or the rock? Now, what Jesus is trying to tell us in this story is, you know, life has lots of hard things that happen. You know, like we fight with siblings. Maybe we didn't have a great day at school. Maybe we got in trouble with our parents. Things happen like that, like the wind and the rain and the storms. And we have a choice to make. We have to decide, are we going to build on the sand or the rock? Now, what do those really mean? So if we look, the rock is Jesus. Are we gonna build our life and our decisions on the rock? Now, if we think about a rock, it's pretty hard. If you throw it at someone's face, it's gonna hurt, right? If we think about it, the palace is never gonna fall down. It is solid, it is secure, and it's not gonna let you down. But if you think about the sand is like this world. This world is gonna let us down. It is not firm, okay? We build our house on the sand and those things start happening that are difficult. Arguing with other people, with siblings, it's just gonna crumble and wash away. Now, thankfully, we have a choice. We can decide, now, am I gonna build my life and the decisions that I make on the world, on the sand, that's gonna let us down and crumble as soon as hard things happen? Are we gonna build our house on the rock that is Jesus, who never, ever, ever will let us down, who is firm and is always dependable? Which would you rather have? I think I'd rather have a house that I can always trust and depend on. Now, what good news is this story? We have this choice of Am I going to trust the world? Am I going to trust Jesus? And the good news is, Jesus is on offer if you just accept him. He is the rock that will never, ever, ever let us down. And that's the choice that we have today. Thanks for joining us. See you next week. Hey, we hope you enjoyed the lesson from Renee today about the wise and foolish builders, and we're here to give you an idea for an activity you can try at home. I'm Paige, and I'm on the team at Redeemer Queens Park, and this is
Eli
and
Hannah.
So, what you'll need for the activity is some Legos or any other toy that you can use to help build a structure, and what we're going to build is a house. So, first, watch us as we get our houses built. Okay, so we hope you had fun making your houses. Eli, do you want to show yours off?
This one is mine.
Very good. And then Hannah?
This one is mine.
Well done. So it doesn't matter what it looks like. However you built your house is great. But what we're going to do is we're going to use these houses for an experiment. So I have two plastic containers in front of you. Hannah, what's in this one?
A big solid rock.
A big solid rock to represent the rock from the lesson today. And what's in this one?
Some rice, but we couldn't find any sand.
So the rice represents the sand or the ground that's not solid that the house is built on. So we're going to place our houses on each of these surfaces, and we're going to see as we add water which house budges and moves and maybe even looks like it's going to fall and which house stands firm. Do you have a prediction from the lesson? Do you think, will it be the house on the rock or the house on the sand that will move? What do you think? Okay, let's look and see. Hannah, do you want to go ahead and pour some water in this bucket?
Sure.
And see what happens? Well done. Did the house move at all?
No.
No. Okay, Eli, do you want to pour the water? Maybe pour it on the side right there. Whoa! Did you see? The house looks like it's going to start to float away. And it floated right off the sand. And even as it looked, it's not even on the sand anymore. So, this is just a little activity to help you get a visual for the story today. I hope that you have fun making your houses and putting them in some buckets and playing around with what can you set it on. You can try beans, you can try maybe some wood in one. So, have fun with this, and thank you so much for tuning in.